Actually
Winky.
Working himself out, is
it? What?
There's a guy out here wants to see you about a job.
I'm busy now. Go away, will you, Adolf?
Well, he says he plays the horn.
Plays the horn? Well, where is he?
Because there's a question of timing and talent. And if you got the talent, the timing will eventually work itself out.
Now, close your eyes, hold your nose, and chug-a-lug.
Chug-a-lug?
Hey, you! You down there! How about...
It's a man!
Boy, cut him down!
What are you doing up there?
I'm knitting a sweater.
This is the Hotel Piratino I'm speaking to.
Si, senor. And once again, we do not have cabanas.
Well, wherever it is that people change into their bathing suits.
Bathing suits? Senor, we are 14 miles from the beach.
And needless to say, you don't have a swimming pool.
That is right, senor. But we have a steam room.
No, that won't do. Never mind. Thank you. Yes, thank you! Operator.
Yes.
I want to place a call to a hotel owned by a man named Zapata in Bellport. That's in Andros, in the Bahamas.
Deposit. $6.
I have a credit card.
Oh. Number 3842Z.
As in zero, right?
Right.
I remembered.
I'm so glad.
Now, that is...
But Rob was not to be fooled. He pointed his space gun at Marco, and in a voice that did not reflect the fear within him, said, "In the name of the Junior Terrestrial Rangers, I hereby place you under arrest."
Well, he hasn't... Will you please be careful with that thing? He hasn't shown up here yet.
Report to me as soon as you turn up something.
It's a good thing you didn't become a surgeon.
You had to have a souffle.
You had to forget the eggs.
Well, I had a few other things on my mind.
Which I'm sure you bungled in your usual manner.
Bread pudding.
Remember the milk? This is supposed to be a loaf of raisin rye. I never even heard of raisin rye. What are you doing?
I ordered it.
For you, my friend, in gratitude and in the name of the People's Republic, I present you with a Sergei Prutkin Coexistence Award.
Thank you, sir.
And to you, my friend, I present the Yelena Prutkin Coexistence Award.
Jorgensen, 628.
Yes, Mr. Jorgensen. There you are, sir.
Thank you. Oh, young man.
Yes, sir.
Here is my sample case. It contains very important samples.
You have a vault, do you not, where you keep your ill-gotten gains?
We'll take it away in our office safe for you, sir.
Office safe? My dear young man, this case contains some of the finest jewelry in the Netherlands.
Netherlands?
Netherlands, sir.
Absolutely. It's far too valuable to be tucked away in some office piggy bank.
I assure you, sir, it's a very...
Assure me no assurances, young man. If you like, my property can remain at my side. I'm going back into the casino for a while. Please have some refreshment sent up to my room.
Yes, sir. What kind would you like, sir?
Yes, sir.
Then it seems we are at an impasse.
Well, not necessarily. We could deprive them of their utopia.
And how exactly do we do that?
We sink the ship.
We sink the ship?
That's right. We manufacture a bomb, place it in the engine room, blow out the side of the ship. Everybody has to leave. Plenty of lifeboats.
Excellent. The passengers would have no other choice. They'd have to go.
That's right. Now, one of us has to make an appearance at the party tonight, so enjoy yourself.
Where will you be?
I am going to do a little marketing of my own.
Mr. Barman, your wife has arrived.
It's time to throw out some bait.
You eat, I hope.
Yes, ma'am.
I have to go now. Any information you could give Mr. Kuryakin would be very much appreciated. Oh, and I think he could use another plate of soup. Hits the water, and then the propellant shoots the chemical fungus into the air, and the air currents wash the fungus over the Russian wheat fields. That's it, huh?
The grain shrivels and twists as if it were burning. The whole harvest turns to ash.
So simple, just like a little toy.
Now, I've seen the damage this toy can do. Petkov, Volensk, Belograd. Each missile timed to infect the wheat just as it ripens. The next field to ripen are at Orbesk.
Well, I must be tomorrow.
Well, I would imagine that our Russian friends are getting a trifle irked by now.
One more missile falling on Russian soil will trigger off instant retaliation, then counter-retaliation,
now,
wait
a moment. Are you sure these missiles are coming from America?
Oh, Napoleon. The trajectory pattern proves that every missile was fired within a 50-mile radius of here. Then the casing, ferrous palladium, American. The propellant, trinitrioxysolicitate G, American. The booster coupling, American. Well then, here's another American product. Dr. Jonas Lavimore.
I thought he died 5-6 years ago.
Oh no. Lavimore involuntarily and bitterly retired. He was forced out of the university by people who thought his research too radical. This strain of fungus is one of Lavimore's discoveries. Until last month, Lavimore was here on the West Coast in Southport. Unfortunately, he's disappeared again.
Well, I think I'll take a little sailing trip down the coast of California. How long do I have to find Dr. Lavimore and the missile?
The harvest at Orbesk will be ready on the 20th. The fungus loses its effectiveness after 72 hours. That puts the firing at the 18th.
Ilya.
Well, that's the spy business for you. You can't trust anyone.